Hi, I was looking through this stack of videotapes the other day, and I decided there was actually quite a bit of stuff here that anybody who was interested in the Rainmakers would probably get a kick out of seeing. Some of it was professionally shot, some of it was semi-professionally shot, some of it was just home video stuff. But in the very least, it makes a really good party tape. And it kind of gives you an idea of where we started and where we went and what we accomplished. So here they are. Here we were. Steve, Bob, Rich, and Pat, the Rainmakers.
Sound crew, I'd like to thank you for staying up all night and coming out here and setting up. A lot of work's gone into this. When I first heard these guys, I went, three guys, and look at how much equipment. They don't have any equipment. I mean, come on. But they put out one of the best sounds I've heard, so if you haven't heard these guys, you're in for a real treat. If you have, you already know what I'm talking about. So put your hands together for Steve, Bob, and Rich.
One, two! Skinny girl at home, 'cause this skinny boy wants a big fat blonde. Johnson County, me and my big fat blonde, we like to fight and scratch. I know I'll be the loser of the wrestling match with a big fat blonde. A big fat blonde. Keep your skinny girl at home, 'cause this skinny boy wants a big fat blonde. Eat it up. I'm talking 6 foot Swede, 40, 30, 40, Amazon bombshell, tall, deaf, and dirty, talking 6 foot blonde. Get me in a bear hug. Your sister, I'm doing it for a big fat blonde. Tons of fun. Inside every woman, there's a big fat blonde. If you don't believe me, just give yours a little time. She'll be a big fat blonde. Yes, a big fat blonde.
Mama, mama,
keep your skinny girls at home. Skinny little me wants a big fat blonde, blonde.
It's time to
just got back today.
the boys with the horns get down and blow. They rear back, aim their bells at the stars. They said, beat me, Big Daddy, eight to the bar. I did not put you here to suffer. I did not put you here to whine. I put you here to love one another and to get out. Everybody always picking on me. I did not put you here to suffer. No, I did not put you here to whine. I put you here to love one another. Yes, and the kid I'd have.
The band, once known as Steve, Bob, and Rich, were on their way to becoming national recording artists. By their own estimate, they've spent about 48 hours out of the last 6 months at home in Kansas City until last week and their triumphant return.
I'm not a native of Kansas City, but I've been here 5 or 6 years. I've always lived close to Kansas City, and that's where I always came to see concerts and, you know, and see Bruce and Sting and, you know, everybody that I admired. And to get to play the Uptown and headline and fill the place two nights is, that's something I wanted to do for a long time. And to get, and finally when the night comes where you're finally getting to do it, that's an emotional experience, it really is.
Would the clerk please read the special actions?
And the days were a bit out of the ordinary too. Mayor Berkeley declaring Thursday, October 2nd, Rainmakers Day.
We appreciate the very positive recognition they're giving Kansas City across the country.
It's funny what you'll say when you're in front of the city council and realizing you're going to have to say something. And I said something about rock and roll as being an outlaw force or something. And I walk away going, outlaw force? Where did I come up with that?
What he probably meant is that this is not culture with a capital C. Even though Big Fat Blonde does mention J.D. Salinger, its appeal is, well, pretty basic. Then there's Rockin' at the Tea Dance, with its images of Apollo 13 and the Hyatt disasters. Not a likely candidate for Kansas City's theme song.
I had the title Rockin' at the Tea Dance for a long time, and I was saying, Bob, don't write that song. You know, this is gonna, it's just too sensitive a subject in Kansas City, don't write that song. But I carried the title around, and then one time we were playing in Lincoln, Nebraska, and I was thinking about Charles Starkweather and all that craziness that went on up there a long time ago. Just realized how much craziness there is in the world, and wrote the whole song real fast, and Rockin' at the Tea Dance, I couldn't say no to it any longer. It was determined to be a song, and so it became a song.
You stare at the ground, you look at your clock, you count your money, you lock your locks. Sometimes you look in my eyes and your face don't move. That's when you'll hear me yelling at you.
I've always had a knack for picking up a subject that maybe there haven't been a lot of songs written about, rather than trying to write yet, you know, the 5 millionth love song that's going to be the love song. I figure I'm probably going to have a harder time writing a better love song than Yesterday or something. So I want to write a song about something that no one's written about. And there are lots of subjects out there that haven't been touched on. So I like to find those subjects and then put my 2 cents worth in it.
One very noticeable difference in the band is that Bob has abandoned the stand-up drums he used to play in favor of a more traditional frontman approach that allows him to concentrate on singing. Also gone are most, but not all, the cover tunes that used to dot their repertoire.
16 ton, and what do you get? Another day older, a neighbor in debt. Say, Peter, don't you call me, 'cause I can't go. To the company store.
The Rainmakers blend of music that keeps both your mind and your feet active was born at small clubs like the old Parody Hall here on 39th Street and other night spots where the prime directive was definitely to twist and shout. The group's new name was chosen to reflect their Midwestern roots and wasn't even arrived at till after the album was completed. If the record company had had their way, another cinematic title would have been chosen, Missouri Breaks.
It is a business, and I don't mean to imply that we don't think we're going to sell a lot of records and make money and things like that, but honestly, we like the music. I mean, the whole company is turned on by the music, and the guys themselves work real hard, which, of course, always encourages you to work harder. So, we're very enthusiastic.
It's kind of up and down, kind of an emotional roller coaster right now, because some cities where radio's been supportive of our record, the crowds are wonderful.
Right.
They know the songs, they know the words, they want to rock it up. Some cities, we get there and there's a few places where no one knows who we are.
So. Right, yeah.
And there are a few places where they've created a little stir, particularly with this song.
Give a man a free house and he'll bust out the windows, put his family on food stamps. Now he's a big spender, no food on the table. The bills ain't paid 'cause he's spending on cigarettes and PGA. They'll turn us all into beggars 'cause they're easier to please. They're feeding our people that government cheese.
And did they really boo in New York on government
cheese?
Just
a couple guys.
They're just noisy. It's been blown out of proportion.
Yeah, it really has.
Just a couple guys from the Bronx who wanted to,
I don't know,
a couple liberals.
He's the man in the White House, the man under the steeple, passing out drugs to the American people. I don't believe in anything, nothing is free. They're feeding our people that government cheese.
Walkenhorst admits a lot of his songs are pretty cynical. Still, the small-town preacher's kid seems to be taking the band's newfound success in stride, filling nearly every waking hour with one kind of promotion or another.
And it's fun to go to radio stations and get to act silly on the air, and it's fun to go. It's been real fun today here at Sound Warehouse to sign autographs for people and, you know, meet the people that are buying the record and have something to tell you about it. I mean, I'm singing it and they're listening to it. I mean, we need to meet each other. I like that feeling. It's not work.
Coming up, the hometown boys make good.
And they have a name that seems to fit right in. They're called the Rainmakers, and they've made quite a timely return as we endure yet another night of soggy weather.
They're a Kansas City band made good. Newsweek magazine recently calling their new record the year's most exciting debut. And with such high praise still ringing in their ears, the group is making a triumphant return home to a sold-out concert at the Uptown Theater.
That's where Bob Thill is tonight with one of our live units. Why this sudden national attention, Bob?
Well, Cynthia, the Rainmakers think it's because they play music with a message. Now, that is definitely not new. As you know, there are plenty of message songs in the 1960s and the early 70s. But this band seems to have cut through the hype and the synthesizers of the 1980s with a more provocative, controversial sound.
Riles some people up, get some people's attention. Some people like it, some people don't, but they do react to it.
And the Rainmakers are getting plenty of attention these days, spending this afternoon signing autographs, lots of them, at an area record store. And what's refreshing about it is they loved it. The band first came together 3 years ago. You might have known them then as Steve, Bob, and Rich, as they played in a couple hundred mile radius of Kansas City. Now with their first album close to cracking Billboard magazine's top 100, the Rainmakers' blend of realism and rock could be on its way.
Powerful, I'd just say very powerful for the amount of people that they have in the band.
Dance-oriented rock and roll, but you can take it home and read the lyrics and listen to the ideas, and there's something there for the mind also.
Singer Steve Walkenhorse lyrics definitely hit home. A song about government cheese giveaways booed in New York. A tune called Rockin' at the Tea Dance. Sure to be an attention getter here.
We're not trying to capitalize on someone's misfortune. We're trying to just say, remember this happened and remember why, and let's take some responsibility in our jobs.
Social awareness and originality aside, their music is also good to the ear.
So the Rainmakers are definitely on a roll. They're enjoying themselves and their success. They're in that period where everything is still new to them, and they're just as amazed by all of this as are their fans. And they'll soon start a national tour with a group called Berlin.
Somewhere downstream, gonna meet you in the water. Somewhere downstream, the Mississippi. Mississippi River flowing downstream. Meet the Gulf of Mexico somewhere downstream. Meet the Atlantic Ocean somewhere downstream. Gonna meet you in the water somewhere downstream.
It's more music time now here on KC Prime. There is a group used to be known as Steve, Bob, and Rich. They added another member. They recorded a video. They got some play on MTV. They have a record contract, a new album in the stores, and it seems like success has come to the local group called the Rainmakers. Well, they're over at Sound Recorders here in Kansas City doing some rehearsing tonight, and we made them stop for just a minute so we could talk to them a little bit here on KC Prime. So let's say, hello, Rainmakers.
Hello, Dick.
Hi.
Hello.
Hi.
Kansas City.
I want you to introduce yourself, guys, and I want you to do it starting with the most talented first.
Rich Ruth. Bass guitar,
of course.
In order of decreasing talent, Bob Walking Horse, lead vocals, rhythm guitar.
Steve Phillips, lead guitar, vocals.
Pat Tommy, drums.
Well, guys, now that the national exposure has come, can you still live in Kansas City?
You can live anywhere you want to, as far as the rock and roll business goes, because basically a rock and roll band lives in a van or a tour bus most of their life. But I plan on staying in Kansas City. I like living here. I've seen New York and seen a lot of other places, and I like Kansas City.
Bob, where was the new video shot that we're going to see here?
We shot it outside of Minneapolis in a little town called Carver, which is like a little lake community. It had two or three churches, and we got to use one of their churches for our video, which we felt a little funny about, but they liked the idea. So.
One last question, guys. Are you rich yet?
He's rich.
Yeah,
I've been rich all my life.
Well, good luck, guys.
You can't say that we don't scour the world for new acts for you. Here, for the first time on British TV, are the Rainmakers, all the way from Kansas City, Missouri. They've been hailed as the leaders of new American rock. And here they are with their new single, Let My People Go Go, and Long Gone Long.
Like I said, we come from Kansas City, Missouri. That's a long ways from home. We drove a long way to get here. So this is a song about being a long ways from home.
Older than I used to be, younger than I'm gonna be. Fewer things puzzle me than when I was young. But when my pace is falling slack, I catch myself thinking back. A certain night, a certain summer, long gone long.
Thank you.
Special guests from Kansas in the USA, the Rainmakers.
always picking on me. I did not put you here to suffer. No, I did not put you here to whine. I put you here to love one another. Yes, and the queen that I have a good time now, now, now. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Hey, you got it, oh, you got it.
In the summer of 1987, we returned to Ardent Studios in Memphis and with producer Terry Manning recorded our second album, Tornado.
Tornadoes are the wrath of nature, or the wrath of Mother Nature, or the wrath of Father Nature, or the wrath of God, or somebody. They're angry.
Is the lion's den. I hope you knew that before you came in. This is where the angels and the devils fight, and they're choosing up sides tonight. Good time!
read you some reviews from England. Let's see. This guy in the New Musical Express writes, "What the flippin' flip is going on? Nobody in the world has ever heard of the Rainmakers. Nobody has any of their records, and yet their singles are in the charts, and the Astoria is full of people who know all the words."
Freak typhoon hit, tour manager struck by a bolt of lightning. It rains every time we play, and we're from Kansas. We're looking for a new name.
This is Rocky. Or else it's Springsteen.
Born in the USA! Born!
Are you ready? Ladies and gentlemen, the band that brings to Kansas City their own version of Hurricane Gilbert, Mercury recording artist, the
song Small Circles is about, well, it's about romance, which is that's a new subject for the Rainmakers. We haven't had a lot of songs about relationships. It's about boy meets girl. They move in small circles, one to another. Those circles keep getting bigger until there's a little too much distance between you and you lose each other.
being not necessarily, you know, so removed, but not in a big major music market, did you find it difficult to break out of that?
It's removed, I think, and I think being removed affects the music. I think because being from Kansas City, when you hear about New York or Los Angeles, I mean, it sounds like another planet. It sounds like you're talking about Mars. But I think it affects the music. We tend not to be so industry conscious. We tend to just maybe look at life a little more instead of looking at what trends are happening, because the trends don't get to Kansas City for a long time.
Yeah. Well, this kind of goes in. Do you find that you sort of are removed yourself? I mean, I know you're not a very media heavy person. I'm told that you don't have a television and you only have an AM radio.
I'm on the wrong show, aren't I?
No, that's okay. We love that. You only have an AM radio too. Why is that?
I grew up like a TV-aholic, you know. If I have a television around, and I do, I don't have one at home, but I spend a lot of my time in hotels and motels, so I have seen your show before. I just get more done if I don't have a television at home.
Okay, that's fair.
Yeah, you asked me.
Yeah, well, you're touring right now. We're also going to take a look at the video, talk about the tour, talk about the album a little bit. But right now, I have to tell you about these videos that are coming up. We've got REM on the way, George Harrison, and Terrence Trent D'Arby, and more with Bob.
She reached out and twisted my hand and made me dance with some local band. But the beat was slow, so there we stand, and we move in small circles. We cut out before the night was through. Start my car and we drove the loop. Talked about the things we were going through. As we move in small circles, we move in small circles. She said she didn't know the ways of love. I said, neither do I. Thought you'd show me some. We dilly-dallied like that for 6 or 8 months. As we move in small circles, a couple of times she stayed with me, and we worked it out on a single sheet. I can hear every painful squeak. As we move in small circles, we move in small circles. Whoa. People that we don't even like. As we move in small circles, we move in small circles. And I don't even think about her now. I just said all this to be working my mouth. I wish I cared, but I don't know how. As we move in small circles, we move in small circles.
We ended 1988 and started the new year of 89 in Austin, Texas, and in Los Angeles with producer Jeff Glicksman, recording our third album, The Good News and the Bad News.
Inside. million, left his wife and children, lived himself to death in a couple of years. Should have spent it on love, spent it on his children, spent it on the ones who need it the most. Take your little bundle, put her in a basket, leave her on the doorstep of the future, her home. Spending it on guns and rolls of barbed wire. Blew it all away, they're homeless and they're hungry. Had to buy the bullet, taste of bloody war. Spend it on love, spend it on the children, spend it on the ones who need it the most. Take a little bundle, put her in a basket, leave her on the doorstep of the future, her home. Where they say the cities all have pretty streets that are paved with gold. They may not be gold, but they were built by people paying heavy taxes for a dream they still hold. Spend it on love, spend it on the children, spend it on the ones who need it the most. Take your little bundle, put her in a basket, leave her on the doorstep of the future, her home. Spend it on love, spend it on the children, spend it on the ones who need it the most. Take a little bundle, put her in a basket, leave her on the doorstep of the future, her home. Got to spend it on love, spend it on the children, spend it on the ones who need it the most.
Has anyone seen Rich?
Nah, he's bringing me in. He's passed out.
Oh my God.
Oh God, is he all right?
Some girls in
two out in the woods, this one place where there's these abandoned houses, had a little pond behind this one. We go there.
Here we are at the Market Hall in Hamburg.
There was this, like, an old wine cellar didn't have a roof anymore. And it was old.
There's Scandinavian for me.
Yeah, I got an extra one. Okay, budget.
I'm ready.
All right. It's been our pleasure to get to be part of this party, this extravaganza. And we're going to be right down there in the middle of the crowd when we get done here. So come up, say hello, buy me a beer. I'm expecting about 3,000 beers tonight, all right? Anyway, I was talking about Daredevils over there, Shooting Star in here, Asleep at the Wheel over there. The Big Ball coming down outside. It's New Year's Eve, have a great New Year. Guys. Just kidding.
There's a hungry little mother, Lindsay in a shack, spitting distance from the capital, down by the tracks. Limos drive 5 blocks ahead of the way, cause seeing that stuff just spoils the day.
Break up.
Yeah. All your nerves, tyrants arise, arms.